Welcome. Good morning. And welcome from North Carolina. It's a beautiful day here in North Carolina. I pray all is well with you and your family and where you're located. If you join me this morning, I want you to please note where you're watching from. And I'm excited to be online this morning, excited about the things of the Lord. We serve a good God, and we continue to give Him praise and thanksgiving and glory and honor. Amen. Praise the Lord. You know, His mercies are new every morning. So if we mess up the day before, we can just rest assured that God's mercy is going to start all over the next day. He's not going to hold it against us. We're not going to be held, you know, and all we have to do is repent. If you make a mess up, you do something you shouldn't have done, just repent. Ask God to forgive you, and we'll walk on through this day, a new day. Amen. If you're joining me, please let me know where you're coming from or where you're watching from. God is good all the time. Amen. Glory. Good morning, Miss Donna. I'm glad you're watching this morning. It's good to have you on with me. Praise the Lord. Praise God. It's a good day to serve the Lord. It's a good day where we are living. So we're going to get into the word in a few minutes. But, you know, I just wanted to share a little bit about some testimonies that that I got this week. I'm so excited. I know some of you shared with me. And one of them was that God supernaturally, out of the blue, gave a job promotion and a substantial pay increase. Praise the Lord. I was so excited. That was just like an answer to prayer. So we were just really rejoicing over that, and seeing God work into that life, into that situation, and knowing that His favor and His goodness is following them all the days of their life. Praise the Lord. Amen. And then I got another praise report, and I'm excited about this one too. There was in this business that they had, they were dealing with something that was going to have to be put on hold. They weren't going to be able to do it. And we just stood and prayed. Good morning, Gwen. I'm glad you joined me this morning. This person was praying and believing God, and before you know it, in the next breath, God did something. He took a no way situation and turned it into a yes way. So we were excited and praising the Lord. We just rejoiced in God. And I'm telling you, good morning, Miss Millie. I'm glad you joined on. Thank you. And so, you know, look for the goodness of God in your life. Look for it. Even if it's a little minute thing, begin to look for His goodness and the good things. If you even start feeling just a slight bit better, start praising the Lord. Start thanking Him for it. Give Him glory for it. Then you'll see the rest of it flow really fast. I believe. Good morning, Sanchez family. I'm glad you're joining this morning. Good to see you. Praise God. Amen. Praise the Lord. You know, I know there's a lot of serious things happening in our world and in our nation, but we're not going to get into fear, are we? Nope. We're going to stand in faith. We're going to trust the Lord with all of our heart. We're not going to lean to our own understanding. We're going to just acknowledge Him. And He's going to make our path straight. Amen. So let's just trust God and don't get weary in well-doing. Don't get fearful. Don't start looking at the news and start fretting over what they're telling you. Just keep in faith. Keep trusting the Lord. If you want to watch any news, watch the KCM news. They have some, they'll tell you what's going on, but they're going to give you the good news too. So it's enlightening and encouraging as well. Praise the Lord. Amen. You know, I was watching Creflo Dollar this week, and one of the things that he said was, he said, God's grace, and I liked how he phrased this. Now, you might want to write this down. Good morning, Mr. Cole. God's grace is unmerited, abounding provision of the unrestrained operation of God's infinite love towards us, especially to those who depend on him. Let me say that again. Good morning, Miss Kathy. Creflo Dollar said, God's grace is unmerited, abounding provision of the unrestrained operation of God's infinite love towards us, especially to those who depend on him. So we're going to depend on him, and we're going to have the grace of God to get through all of these things that we see that are disconcerting, that are just kind of mulling over in our mind, that probably fear tries to present itself. So we're going to stay in that place so we can experience the unmerited abounding provision of God's unrestrained operation of his infinite love towards us. Amen. That's a mouthful, he said, but it's well worth what it says. Praise God. It's very enlightening. Now, as a Christian, you and I know we have the privilege and the responsibility, first of all, to pray. We need to pray. We need to pray for our brothers, our sisters in the Lord. We need to lift up pastors and ministers and missionaries. We need to pray for the military. We need to pray for our government. There are so many people we can pray for, and there's people that you probably know that are hurting and going through something. We need to be responsible praying for them as well. And then also the word says for us to encourage one another. 1 Thessalonians 5:11 says, therefore encourage and comfort one another and build up one another. You know, how are we supposed to build each other up? To see the possibilities. With God, all things are possible. So we need to stay in that mindset that all things are possible. God's going to work everything out for his good, for our good, in the timing that he has. We just have to stand in faith and see it happen. Amen. Yeah, there's doom and gloom in the world. Yes, COVID has reared its ugly head again, but faith is the victory that overcomes the world. We have to stay in faith. It's our job as believers, first of all, to identify the foe. What is this foe? If it's COVID, it's COVID. We're going to speak to it, and we're going to tell it who God is. Who is God? And what we're going to do in the power of his might, just like David did Goliath. Now, what did David say to Goliath? In 1 Samuel, David said, you come against me with sword and spear and javelin, but I come against you in the name of the Lord Almighty, the name that's above every name, the God of the armies of Israel, whom you defy. And this day the Lord will hand you over to me, and I'll strike you down and cut off your head. You know, I think the thing, if you recognize what the enemy is trying to do, he's trying to steal your faith. He's trying to steal your joy. He's trying to steal your goods. He's trying to make God look bad. But if you realize, if you cut off his authority, see, head in the Bible represents authority. So cut off his authority in your life. You see, our conflict isn't with flesh and blood. It's not with flesh and blood. It's not against Sister Bucket Mouth. It's not against Miss Complainy. It's not against all of those people, those situations, the guy behind the counter that's not talking nice to you, maybe Mr. Rude. It's not about all of those people. We're not dealing with the people. It's against principalities and powers and rulers of darkness and spiritual wickedness in the heavenly places. The only way to overcome through the Spirit is to pray in the Spirit. Pray in the Spirit. You've got to pray in the Holy Ghost, because we don't know what to pray for a lot of times. Our little menial minds just don't think about everything. We don't know it all. So we've got to pray in the Spirit, and we've got to speak life and declare righteousness. Amen. You see, we've been given the authority to tread upon serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt us. Amen. God gave us the keys to the kingdom. Amen. We're the church. We're the body of Christ. We are seated with him in heavenly places. And so when we use that authority in the name of Jesus and using the keys to the kingdom, which is binding and loosing or permitting and prevent or prohibiting or forbidding and loosing, which is permitting, we are ruling and reigning with Christ. So that's what we have to do. We have to remember to do that in all situations. Now, yes, we're going to experience some stormy times. But what that does is it reveals to each one of us, it reveals where is our faith right now by the way we're responding to what we're dealing with. Amen. Where's our faith? It's going to tell us that. And if we find that there's some situations in our faith, maybe we need to reexamine. Amen. Praise the Lord. So don't be shaken and don't be moved by the strategies of the devil, because he's just a liar. He doesn't speak the truth. The truth is in God's word. What God said is the ultimate truth. It weighs above all of those things. Amen. Praise the Lord. Greater is he that's in us than he that's in the world. Amen. There's no fear in God, so we have to stay in the spirit and in him. Now, somebody probably just said, well, how do you do that? How do you stay in the spirit? Well, first of all, you got to pray in the spirit. You got to renew your mind to the word of God. Get in the Bible. Find out what God says about these situations. And then begin to quote that. Begin to say that instead of the situation. Amen. I just want to encourage you today to remain steadfast and strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Amen. Praise the Lord. It's not enough that we want to be healed. It's not enough that we want no lack in our life. It's not enough that we don't want to face situations. We don't want those in our life. It's not enough. We have to purpose faith. We have to be purposeful in exercising faith with everyday situations, not just in the emergency times. Yes, when emergencies come and situations arise and we're faced with something, good morning, Mr. Ed. When those things happen, we have to stay in faith and purpose to be in faith over those things. Go to the word first. Don't start getting all flustered and frustrated and excited about what the problem is. Begin to say, well, God's word says this about that. And say it and rely on it. Amen. And that the God kind of faith operates by saying. Amen. By saying. That's what the God kind of faith operates by. We find that in Mark 11 in verse 22 and 23. In verse 22 it says, And Jesus answered and said unto them, have the faith of God. That's the God kind of faith. Verse 23 says, for I say to you, whoever shall say to this mountain, be taken away and cast into the sea, and shall not doubt or waver in his heart, but shall believe that those things which he say shall come to pass, then he will have what he says. Amen. Praise the Lord. It shall be done. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. You see, God called those things that be not as though they were. Faith without saying is just wanting. That's all it is. Faith without saying is wanting. So we got to speak to the mountain. Amen? Amen. Praise the Lord. Somebody says, well, what do I say to the mountain? Say the word. Find a word on it. Whatever your situation is, if it's finances, if it's healing, whatever it is, say to the mountain. Say the word to it. Speak what God says. And don't give it your opinion. Don't give it Sister Sue's opinion. Give it the word of God, what God says about it, because that's the ultimate. There's no weapon that can be formed against that. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Well, this morning, before I get started, that was just preliminary. That was free. So this morning, let's pray. Let's pray. Father God, praise you, praise you, praise you, Father. We just come before you. We just give you glory and thanksgiving for all the wonderful things that you're doing, for your goodness, for your grace, your mercy. Thank you, Lord, for your provision in our life. Thank you for your healing power and operation in our life. Thank you, Father. We just praise you this morning. Praise you, praise you, Lord. And Father, right now, I lift up the pastors and spiritual leaders and missionaries across our nation, across the nations of other world, of the other places in the world. And Father, I pray for them to be strong in you and in the power of your might. We come against a spirit of fear, and we pray for them to be bold in Christ. Lord, we pray and plead the blood of Jesus over them. We pray that the enemy's eyes are blinded, that he cannot see them, and they are able to complete the mission to which you've called them to do by preaching the gospel to the nations. And Father, right now I lift up and pray for the Afghanistan Christians and the military there, the personnel. Lord, we pray for them. We plead the blood of Jesus over everyone, that your protection surrounds them, and that they are able to do what you call them to do. She bronde ende balomonda esaraci di katala maso brate. Lord, I lift up our government, the leaders in our government. I pray for them to have the wisdom of God, that your wisdom will infiltrate. Si vara mende eso ningara la hashi se vora minga endando eso no loba si karabasha tala etal abasita. We come against that spirit of COVID in the name of Jesus. We render it harmless and ineffective against the body of Christ, against the people of God in Jesus' name. We arrest you in Jesus' name. We speak healing to the bodies across this nation, people that are dealing with sickness, symptoms of disease or infirmities in their body. We speak for that sickness to desist in its maneuvers against them, in Jesus' name. And I thank you, Father, for healing. I thank you, Father, for restoration of health. I thank you for restoration of things stolen, of finances stolen, of relationships stolen. Restoration, those things restored right now. You are the God of restoration. Thank you, Father. Praise you for it. Lord, we thank you for an awakening to God that is happening across our nation, in our neighborhoods, in our families. And it begins with us. Thank you, Father. Thank you. It's beginning with us. Father, Lord God, we are awakened to the spiritual things and your word. Thank you, Lord. We thank you for salvations. We give you praise, Lord. We thank you for ears to hear what the Spirit of God reveals to us today in Jesus' name. And we say, amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Excuse me. You know, one of the things the Lord impressed upon me this week was, was the importance of sowing and how it affects our reaping. You know, everyone sows, not just money. I'm talking, we sow in everyday life. We sow in our activities. We sow in our attitude. We sow in our words. We sow every day. Galatians 6:7 in the Amplified Version says, do not be deceived. That word deceived means led astray, led off course, affected by an outside influence, or led in the wrong direction. So he says, do not be deceived. Don't be led in the wrong direction. God is not mocked. He will not allow himself to be ridiculed or treated with contempt, nor allow his precepts to be scornfully set aside. For whatever a man sows, and this only is what he's going to reap. God is not mocked. God is not mocked. In this verse, Paul is adamant, and he's saying God is not mocked, which means that to turn one's nose up at someone, like laughing or mocking and making a joke on them or making fun of the person. It's like saying, come on, you don't believe that, do you? That's really stupid. That's really dumb. That's what mocking is. I like one translator or reference that I looked at referred to it as people who are generally reacting this way had a bad experience. It didn't turn out the way they thought. They didn't get the result they wanted. So they turn their nose up at the validity of it. They say, well, that's not always the case. We don't give back what we give. It just doesn't happen that way. So they're going to mock the situation, mock God's word at it, and they're not going to take it respectfully. But the word says whatever, for whatever a man sows, that's what he's going to reap. And this one translation said that whatever means no matter what. No matter what a man says, no matter what a man sows, no matter what, any seed, it's saying any seed sown. So it could apply to our kindness. It could apply to generosity, as well as anger or frustration or harsh words. Those things, when we sow that kind of seed, we're going to reap that kind of seed. It also applies to bitterness, wrath, selfishness, unforgiveness, patience, and money. It applies to all of these areas. This law of God applies. There's no exceptions. No exceptions. Whatever. If we sow it, we're going to reap it. That's just the way it is. You know, Pastor Michael taught us years ago that this meaning of sowing is not just a one-time sowing. This meaning, this he used it, he said a Greek tense of this meaning is translated to mean whatever a man sows and sows and sows and sows and sows and sows. In other words, that's perpetual. It's constant sowing of a seed. Then he's going to reap whatever he sows. It's, you can't just sow a one-time harvest and expect you to reap and reap and reap. It doesn't happen that way. This word, when he says, and whatever a man sows, that's what he's going to reap, is the same word as the sowing is, the same Greek tense. It means whatever a man sows and sows and sows and sows, that's what he's going to reap and reap and reap and reap, because that's how it happens. That's what it's going to happen. Amen. Amen. So sowing one time and waiting for the harvest isn't how it works. It doesn't work that way, because nothing happens. Amen. It works in this same precept will work in every area of our life. You know, one day I could lose it one day, and when I'm at the store and somebody treat me rude and I get rude back, but that doesn't mean it's going to come back to me every time, all the time, all the time. Because if I catch that, repent of it, and decide, I'm not going to do that. God, I'm sorry. I shouldn't have acted that way. Please forgive me. Then I'm not going to reap and reap and reap that. It's when we're repeatedly rude. It's when we repeatedly do something, we're going to see the return of that in our lives. So I guess what we should do is start looking, what are we reaping in our life? What are we seeing that we're reaping? What's happening in our lives? Then we can see what we're sowing. That's pretty good, isn't it? Amen. I didn't write it. God did. Hallelujah. 2 Corinthians 9:6 in the Amplified Version says, now remember this, he who sows sparingly will reap sparingly, and he who sows generously that blessings may come to others will also reap generously and be blessed. Amen. Praise the Lord. So it depends on what we're going to sow, the level or the extent, or what he calls it, the measure that to which we sow will determine the measure to which we reap. Amen. Our consistency makes a difference. Amen. Sowing inconsistently will not guarantee consistent reaping. Amen. Praise the Lord. You know, think about this farmer, and we've heard this story many, many times about the farmer that goes out to sow the seed. If he doesn't plant a pretty generous crop, he's not going to get one back. Amen. So you've got to sow. But seed produces much after itself, so you need to continually sow and continue to sow. You know, in the Bible, there's an example of the widow woman who and her son who were in the middle of the famished land when there was no drought and there was no water, there was no food, and it was difficult, and she was just gonna cook this little bread for herself and she was going to die. And I think if you realize what God did for her, he didn't send her food. He sent her the man of God. He sent her Elijah for her to sow into, someone to sow into, so that she would continue to reap, that she would continue to be blessed, because that's where the blessing comes, when you sow and you sow. Because Elijah told her, if you'll go fix this cake for me first, sow into me first, because you're sowing into the man of God first, then you will not lack. And that's exactly what happened. Praise the Lord. So it's important. And you know, one thing about sowing a seed is a seed doesn't stop growing. It doesn't stop growing. They have found seeds thousands and thousands of years old, and then they planted them and they grew. Praise the Lord. It doesn't stop growing unless we dig it up. Now we, or stop watering it, then we kill it. But what we have to do, we have to keep watering it with our faith. Don't water it with doubt and unbelief, because what you're doing is you're digging that seed up. It's not going to produce. Amen. Got to watch out what you confess and say the right thing over it. Speak the word over it. Amen. You can do that over all the seeds you've planted. That's faith. When you speak what God says about your seed and believe for it to come back on every wave, then you'll see a harvest. Praise the Lord. Amen. The seed knows what to do, I'm telling you. We don't have to dig it up. We don't have to see, well, is it growing? I just wonder, what is it doing? We don't have to do that. We just continue to plant the seed, pray over it, believe over it, speak the word over it, and watch for it to come back, because you're going to see it happen in your lives. And I know many of you have a great testimony of God's harvest in your life, don't you? I know you do. Praise the Lord. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. You know, I have testimonies. The Lord has done awesome, wonderful things over our lifetime to bring in the finances, that miraculous things, because we kept our sowing going. Amen. Praise the Lord. It's important to realize that everything we do or say is planting a seed. You know, we're either planting a seed of fear or planting a seed of faith. So what are we saying? When we say it even to ourselves, we're planting the seed of faith. Are we planting a seed of fear in our lives? And when we say it to others, what are we encouraging them to do? To be into fear or be into faith? So we want to make sure what we speak is we speak God's word, which is faith. Amen. So be sure you're planting that. Take a look at the seeds that you're sowing and make sure you're sowing seeds of faith. And the only way to dig up those negative seeds is to repent. So ask God to forgive you for all those things you said, or all those things, how your faith was in fear, and ask him to forgive you, and then decide to make the change, and then be constant with your faith. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Well, I'm coming to an end, and I hope that this word has encouraged you today and maybe even brought some inspiration or motivation to you to become more conscious of what you're saying and the faith and the word of God in your life. Amen. And if it did, why don't you share it with someone? Share it with somebody that needs it, because, you know, we all need encouragement. We all need to be uplifted every day. And sometimes when you're praying, or maybe you're just sitting around your house, and all of a sudden somebody comes to mind, do you know that God has laid them on your heart? Why don't you give them a call? Text them. Ask them, how are they doing? Is there something I can pray with you about? Let them know you're thinking about them. Let them know that God put them on your heart. And I think they'll be blessed because of it. I know I am. When people call me or send me a text, how you doing? What's going on? And it blesses my heart. I get cards in the mail. Keep those cards and letters coming. I'm blessed so much by your cards and letters and your inspirational words of encouragement. It helps me. It strengthens me. It just gives me a reason to believe, yes, I'm going on. I can make this. Amen. I want to thank you this morning for watching. I want to pray that the Spirit of the Lord continue to empower you to remain strong and steady in faith. And I pray that the enemy's strategies are revealed and neutralized in the name of Jesus. I pray for you to be the light and to speak life into people's lives. I pray that you bring hope and encouragement to all those you come in contact with. I pray for the Spirit of the Lord to work in your life and for all the desires of your heart to be made manifest and that you will get that job that you want, that you will get the finances that were stolen, that you'll get your healing right now in the name of Jesus. I pray that every seed of faith that you've planted will produce a mega harvest. Amen. Financially, emotionally, physically, and spiritually. And I praise you, God, for it in Jesus' name. I love you all. Thank you again for tuning in. Keep in touch. God bless you. And remember, in His presence is fullness of joy.